Hello, it's me, NBZ. I'm here, I'm your host. I love double jumps, they're great. What is better in a video game than a good double jump where you go high in the air and then you just hit a peak and then you go high again? It's fantastic. I love video game double jumps, and so I'm just going to rank them now in this video. I hope you enjoy, thank you. Alright, we've got Bloodstained Ritual of the Night here. Has a pretty fantastic double jump. Lots of good things to like about this. So one of the things I'm going to note is like, the point at which you can double jump is like whenever you want. You can do like little tiny double jump in the air, like almost a hover. You've got a nice wing effect animation that comes out the back of Miriam. Some nice color to it, some good animation. There is a stiffness to it, of course, because this is a Castlevania-esque game and there's a certain feel to it. But really good height we're getting. Some decent length. You can see we're clearing the entire couch, which is pretty fantastic. And it's just very flexible in the air as well. Like, you can double jump and then attack. It's got a lot of good feeliness to it. It's exactly what you want. It's the tight controls. It's great movement. This is a double jump that you yearn for, really. It's kind of like the best of every world. I gotta give it a 9 out of 10. This is just a quality double jump. You can't argue with it. Pretty much perfection. Devil May Cry 5. Now, this is a hell of a game, of course. Like, it's just stylish, it's amazing. But it has a good amount of platforming action to it. Some good double jump usage. I do like the fact that it shows you the platform. Like, it gives you this blue hovering circle as you do the double jump. Similar to Bloodstained, also has no real delay to it, right? You can do the double jump kind of wherever you are within your range. Like, real good height to it. A decent amount of length. And just great animation. The forward flip is good. Doesn't really have like a backflip animation, which is fine, or a side flip. He's always going to forward flip, which is pretty solid. But you know, that's kind of not what you're here for with Devil May Cry 5. That said, a lot of the action is like, hey, we're going to go in the air and we're going to pull someone up from the air, or we're going to hover mid-air and shoot a gun at the same time. So lots of things that kind of work in its favor. And I like it as a double jump. It's probably not as tight or good as Bloodstained. That's very hard to do. But this is just like a perfectly solid, really nice double jump that, you know, you'll use it here and there during the game. You're not going to go crazy with it, but it's always going to be useful. It's always going to be helpful as a dodging tool. It's an 8 out of 10. It's a solid 8 out of 10. So Hollow Knight, for some reason, we don't have any noise, any sound, because PC gaming, am I right? Hollow Knight's an interesting one. It has really nice flourish in the animation of the double jump, like those glorious wings just spreading out lovingly. It is not quite as high on the second jump as I would like. Like, it does seem like it does 100% of the first jump, but I think the first jump is so small in Hollow Knight that it doesn't quite do exactly what you want. I don't know, actually, it feels pretty good. It's got some nice movement in the air. You can kind of swing it about left and right. You know what, I'm coming around on it. Like, I think my memory of the Hollow Knight double jump was it wasn't great. But this is pretty good, actually. All things considered, I think it has a nice flourish to it. It does get you kind of where you need to be. Obviously, there's like dashes and things as well. But I think that this double jump, it's a solid double jump. It might not be quite an 8. I might go for a 7.5 on this double jump. It's not like doing anything particularly special, but it's not kind of doing anything bad either. I'm going to go with a 7.5 for this Hollow Knight double jump. It feels good. The delay-wise, like, it's a little bit delayed sometimes, but it tends to kind of work out. So I'm going to say 7.5. Hollow Knight, you did all right, friend. Rogue Legacy. Now, talk about just a gorgeous double jump. Just the smoothness with which it executes. Okay, let's just start here on this wooden bit. And we can just, like, dip in at the last minute. Look at the clearage. Look how the length of this double jump goes. It's just such incredible length. The height, not to speak of. You can basically hit the ceiling in one leap. You can delay it whenever you want to do it. You can do a quick hop double jump. You can maneuver right back and forward. It's just so fluid. Nice sound design to go along with the second hop. The hop has a little cloud of air underneath your feet. This is just a double jump the doctor ordered. Gorgeous. This is one of the best double jumps. And I didn't expect going into this to be like, oh yeah, I remember Rogue Legacy having a good double jump, but man, this is a double jump. I mean, it's close to perfect. It's not quite perfect. You know, I'd like some, maybe a bit more animation to it, but as far as it goes, this is just a feel-good double jump. It's the double jump of the day. This is a 9.5. It's an easy 9.5, and I'm not even questioning it. This is the double jump everyone should strive for. Rogue Legacy, just killing it. Next up is Super Lucky's Tale. Now, I re-downloaded this entire game, 10 gigabytes, just to show you that this might be one of the worst double jumps I've ever seen in my life. It is just, it feels awful. Like, your first jump is like, it's okay, it's like a kind of floaty jump. That second jump, it's like, oh, it feels like gravity is just pulling me down to the ground. It feels like I can barely get off my haunches. It's just, the jump wants to pull me right back down. Like, this tiny little extra puff of air. It's agonizing. It's one of the worst feeling video game jumps I've ever felt in my life. It's crushingly bad, to the extent which I didn't want to play the game, mainly as a result of this awful double jump. It just is terrible. I can't abide by it. It's one of the worst double jumps I've ever felt. I can't give it anything less than or anything more than a 1. This is a 1 out of 10 double jump. And you know, in a world where there's so many amazing double jumps, I just, please, Super Lucky's Tale, be better next time. You're a 1 out of 10. You're just terrible. Awful double jump. So Titanfall 2 is an interesting one because it has a good double jump. But really, like, Titanfall is about, like, wall running with double jumps. So it's like, oh, boom and bang and boom, bang, and then, like, midair, bang, bang, bang. You know? That type of deal. Whereas, like, just the double jump on its own, it's good. Like, it's a solid double jump. I like it. It's got a little bit of jetpack boosting to it. But it doesn't quite achieve what one wants from purely just a double jump alone. You know? Like, there's lots of games in these categories of, like, double jump where they get enhanced by the other parts of the moveset, right? Devil May Cry 5, you know, you can hang in the air and, like, shoot as you have double jumped. You know, Jedi Fallen Order. You know, there's extra elements to, with wall running and stuff like that. And because of the wall running, the double jump, it isn't quite on its own, on the face of it. There's, like, a little bit of a delay to it. Like, it gives you a little bit of a puff boost. It feels like a mini puff boost as opposed to a true double jump, right? You know what I mean? Like, it's like, if you have a momentum, then you'll go really far. But unless you've built up the momentum, you don't quite have it. So, unfortunately, Titanfall 2, much as I love it and its movement system is impeccable, if we're just rating the double jump, it's going to be a 7. It's going to be a 7 double jump. Like, it's not an amazing double jump. I think in the context of other things, it pulls it up. But, hey. Okay, so I realized I was going to do Jedi Fallen Order, but then I realized that actually what really happened was that I got it on Origin Access Premiere, and so I don't have access to it anymore. So this is Ogdo Bogdo, and let's just pretend this is Cal Kestis. So basically, the double jump in Jedi Fallen Order is pretty cool, right? So, you know, you can do a double jump like that, or you could just do a forward flip one, which is pretty cool. You can also do a backflip. Oh no, Cal Kestis, Ogdo Bogdo, very scary. And then you can do like a side flip, which is pretty good. So like if he's like shooting a laser at you, he's like, oh wow, I'm Ogdo Bogdo, I'm going to eat you. And you can be like, no, Ogdo Bogdo, I'm going to do a side flip. Oh, super cool. So I think the fact that you get the animations of like the front flip and the back flip and the side flip, it all just kind of comes together. It's a pretty good double jump. I'm going to give it an 8. I think it's worth an 8 and it's a nice double jump. It's pretty good. So Dead Cells is a fantastic game, I'll give you that. I've been addicted to it, it's fantastic, but the double jump's not great, man. Like, it has a nice little animation to it, a little cloudy puff of smoke, but the height you get, it's not fantastic. Now here's the thing, the level design is kind of built around it, right? Like, you can get up to here by double jumping, and like, it has this magnetic thing where you like stick to walls, like you magnetize up them really nicely. So in all honesty, the game itself and its double jump, it works for it, right? It does the job. But the actual pure jump of it, when I first started playing Dead Cells, I remarked, like, you feel really heavy, man, like too weighty in a way that doesn't quite vibe with me on a really good double jump. And if we're talking about just double jumps in isolation, unfortunately it doesn't quite make it. So Dead Cells, I'm gonna have to give it a 5.5. As much as I wouldn't like to do that, it just doesn't meet the criteria for what we're looking at here, which is the purity of the double jump. So Ori and the Blind Forest is one of my favourite games ever. Like, it's fantastic, it's brilliant. Now, we're talking about double jumps here. Ori, the thing with Ori is that its movement is so good, right? You got a triple jump even, and you also have like a dash, you also have the ability to use the bash, which just makes the movement so good. It's kind of like Titanfall in the sense that the real joy of Ori and the Blind Forest is all of the movement abilities tied together. And so, like, the double jump itself, I think it's an okay double jump. It's a pretty good one. It's got a good length to it. Height-wise, it doesn't really knock it, right? Like, you barely make it up to this wall with this height. Because if we're standing still and we're doing a double jump, that doesn't feel great, right? It's not an amazing double jump in its own right. But when you chain it together with a triple jump, with a dash, with a bit of bash all together, that's when it comes together. And as I've said, we're ranking just double jump here. So just on the purity of the double jump itself, it doesn't quite match up. Similar Titanfall, I would say maybe it's a little bit better than that, has a bit of a better feeling, especially the length, like really gets you long distance with it. So I'm going to go a little bit higher. We're going to go with a 7.3 for Ori and the Blind Forest. Not amazing, still pretty good. So here we are with Crash Bandicoot 3 Warped from the Insane Collection. Not a great double jump. This is one of those double jumps where you can't hit it at any point. When you go past the point of no return, especially with a forward arc, like you can't at the last minute jump again. Like I'm trying at the last minute to do another double jump and you can't do it. It doesn't let you, which is one of the worst feeling things about a double jump, right? You want to be able to perform at any point within the jump, right? And Crash not allowing you to, about like that fast falling, really heavy gravitational pull, doesn't let it work, and it's real rough. Now, it's not quite as bad as Super Lucky's Tale, because when you do pull it off, you get a nice amount of height, you got a bit of cool animation, Crash like doing a bit of the splits midair, I like that pizzazz to it. But fundamentally, it doesn't feel good. Obviously, Crash Bandicoot, not a game that feels great in the modern era anyway, but like this double jump, it doesn't quite cut what you want from it, but it still gives you a bit of extra height, a bit of extra movement on some of the trickier challenges platforming wise. So I'm going to go with a 3.5 here. It's not the worst in the world. It will do you solid. Just don't try and do it too late in the jump, because it will screw you over and you'll be very disappointed by it. And here we come to it, the granddaddy of them all, Super Smash Brothers. Really, for me, the only perfect 10 on the list, and it's for many reasons, right? Super Smash Brothers, such a fluidity to the jump. I'm playing as Lucina, who has a great jump. I like her jump a lot. The distance, I mean, look at this. We just fucking pass right over Ridley's head from that distance. Obviously, it helps getting a bit of momentum up, but the thing which really gets me about Smash is that you jump forward and you can do a forward flip, or you can jump and then you can do a back flip. By just performing it in a different way. That backflip is gorgeous. Look at that. The way she arcs her back. I mean, Lucina's obviously the choice here for me, but there are some other good double jumps within the game. Obviously, you know, in Smash Brothers, you get the up B as the kind of extra added bonus, but it's one of those things, unlike Titanfall and unlike Ori, that even without the up B, Smash Brothers has just a brilliant double jump. You know, it has the very slight animation in the air. You can do it very quickly. You know, very quick pop-up. You can, you know, move really smoothly within the air. It gets you amazing distance. It gets you amazing height. It just looks good. It feels good. It's an amazing double jump. It's just what I look for in a double jump. It's better than every other double jump on the list. This is a 10 out of 10 pure god double jump. Well, there we go. Wasn't that a lovely, nice scenario of all the video game double jumps that matter, really? Is there any more? What double jumps do you like? Please let me know in the comments. I appreciate each and every one of your comments. They're very nice. They're good. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye, friends.